Morning. So while last week U.S. markets ended with equities mostly down, this morning in Asia, futures look to trade up. It's worth noting that yields rose further, so the 10-year is at 1.35%, with many investors expecting inflation to pick up. And then gold seems to regain as well somewhat, currently bouncing off a support at 1,775. Now, a lot of money has clearly been flowing from the traditional space and towards the crypto space. Over the weekend, Bitcoin's market cap touched $1 trillion US dollar for the first time ever. Let that sink in. So from Friday's open at 51,600, buyers took us past 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, and 58K on Sunday for a new all-time high at 58,360, so up 10% in those 3 days. Alts may have lost some grounds, but the Bitcoin dominance index remains around 62.5, an okay level. And then Ethereum also rose to a new all-time high and broke the 2,000 resistance, the long-awaited one, to 2,040. Now we've retraced slightly. We're closing the day at 1,930, which is still okay. The picture looks similar across other large cap alts. I'm thinking Chainlink, Polkadot, Cardano, Dash, Bitcoin Cash. Also some decent action, and for the first two, Chainlink and Polkadot to new highs. But then if you look at it relative to Bitcoin, it is indeed in the red, meaning they outperformed somewhat. Now, it's worth noting that the activity on large institutional exchanges seem to have cooled down a bit, with the premium relative to more retail exchanges falling. And that suggests there's a bit less of a USD inflow in those exchanges, and so maybe less strength to push us higher for Bitcoin specifically. Now, almost to contradict that, there is news that MicroStrategy closed their previous offering of their 0% convertible note for a total of $1.05 billion US dollar, essentially money that's going to be put into Bitcoin. And so how it's going to be handled and when remains to be seen, but there's definitely that huge capital that can pour in or has already partly been poured in. Now, depending on whether you're trading short-term or long-term, you'll choose to see those two news differently and trade them differently. For now, we remain bullish. Really interesting to see the net unrealized profit and loss chart, which is at similar level than early January, suggesting that even at these levels, we still have plenty of room before we get overextended. That's it for me today. I wish you a great and a great trading day. If you haven't done so yet, please like, please subscribe. It helps with the visibility, but also means you'll be updated when new videos come out.